You were dreaming. If a meteor fell, it would have wakened people up for miles around.
But it didn't fall, it landed. I saw it. I don't know what it was, Dad. A spaceship or something.
That's us lost.
About time.
You're right.
And will, to the best of your ability, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
It's a balloon, man. Can I get some more clothes, man? Can I, man?
Thanks for doing my washing for me, Monday. You're a wee gem.
Do you really want me to iron this?
I've got a lodge meeting on Friday.
Green for a queen. Cheerio. That's the stuff, son. Come on, hurry up. No got a day.
Balloon.
Balloon? Oh, let's see what you've got first. Oh, yes, very nice. Tell you what, give you a nice big red one for that, eh? There you go. Oh, no, it's a ball burst.
Billy! That's my best tweed skip, your Auntie Nettie in Inverness. Tweed! Next time, ask.
Hard line, son. I'm changing my route. I'm doing Bathgate and Blackburn for now on. This place is no bloody use.
Oh, do what again?
Aye.
Come on then.
Let's go, Harry! Can you tell it, Paul?
Yes!
Right.
On the heat!
Tell it, go away! Oh, it's about the park. Your tea will be ready soon, boys.
You too, Sammy.
10 minutes.
Rita! Look, there's Morris. You get it, not you. That Morris gives me the creeps. You get it, Billy. Go on.
Thank you.
hotel.
Mrs. Stone called. She wants to see some of my drawings.
Who?
Mrs. Stone, up in the wooden houses. She's a teacher at the grammar school, an art teacher.
How'd you know her?
She wrote me a note.
Aye. Well, I'm going to the pub.
It's your brother. He's with that stuck-up Alice Johnson.
Do you want it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, go on.
Well, only if you don't tell anyone. Didn't you mess up my stones?
Dana, done it before.
Has he?
She does.
You got any? You know.
Oh, aye. Aye.
What's this?
I know.
Do you want to get pregnant?
No, do I? I can't have them. I did have them.
This is the last time I'm going out with you. That Lord Brighton asked me out last week. You know that? I'll maybe see youth club dance then. Cheerio.
Mrs. Wilson, they're lovely. Lovely colour sense. You should take it up seriously. Have you ever looked at the work of Cézanne?
Yes, it's very good.
Have you tried the palette knife?
No, not yet.
Well, probably better to wait a while before you start with that.
Have you seen my scarf?
In the middle drawer.
It's a very good likeness.
You got 10 bob?
In my purse.
Matt, look!
Well, I'll be in touch, Mrs. Wilson.
What's that?
Hiya, Eric.
I said, what's that there?
Chewing gum.
Give it.
It's yours.
Square go. Me and you, aye?
Here, take it.
Good boy. Any money?
I'm skint.
Anything else? Come on, turn to your pockets. Aye, well, he's better hit something next time. Or else, you got bloody good hammer him.
Papist. Papist.
Saturn's the way planet.
No, it's not. Miss Murray said it's Pluto.
Donald Duck and Mickey Mouse.
Shut up, Billy. You know nothing about the solar system.
Solar system, second year.
Signs your back. Miss Murray knows nothing.
The Americans are going to send rockets into space. She said so. She said there were other people on the other planet.
She said maybe.
How did they get there?
What?
How did they get there? Another planet?
They were born there, you idiot.
They look like us.
Probably.
Come on. Brace you in the pit. Dad!
Rob Spears says that Prince Philip is a double. It does always work, because Prince Philip is always drunk and falling over. But that, the double is 6 inches wee. And that's why Prince Philip always walks 6 feet behind the Queen, so that nobody notices.
Weir. 6 inches weir.
6 inches weir.
Aye, well, he's probably right. I mean, what are the royal family? What are they? Parasites. What are they?
Parasites.
Parasites.
Jim.
What?
Don't start.
Who's starting?
She'd be talking like that. They're too young for politics.
I just want them to know where they stand. I knew the history of the trade union movement at the time I was his age. I was particularly knowledgeable about the George Square riots.
We interrupt this programme to bring you a news flash. Half an hour ago, the Russians announced they have put a man into space. An announcement broadcast on Moscow radio in English said the world's first spaceship, Vostok, with a man aboard, had been launched on around the Earth orbit. The first space navigator is Yuri Gagarin. Radio communications have been established and maintained with him. He's feeling well, and conditions in the spaceship are normal. The flight is continuing. We will bring you more news as we receive it.
A spaceman, Alex.
From the Earth's shadow, the horizon seemed different. It had a bright orange strip, which then resolved itself into blue, then into pitch black.
Mental!
I did not see the moon. The sun in outer space is dozens of times brighter than it is here on Earth. The stars are clearly visible.
Sounds extravagant.
What?
Extravagant.
Shut up!
We shall welcome the success of the American cosmonauts. There is room in space for everyone. Space should be used for peaceful and not military purposes.
What else does it say?
That's about it.
I wish I was a cosmonaut. I wonder if he met God.
God?
Aye. I wonder. Alex, if God made us, who made God?
Move it, a spaceman. God made God.
Oh, I see. The clouds are made of cotton wool.
So are your brains. You're daft.
Shh. The boy's only young.
Thank you.
David says that he saw something land in the field out back. It doesn't make sense, but he seems so convinced.
What does he mean, land?
Well, he said he saw a bright light or something, and, well, he's not the type of boy that's given to imagining things, you know. After all, the work at the plant is secret, and we have orders to report anything unusual. And there have been rumors.
Rumors?
Oh, Mary, you know I can't talk about that. I better go out and take a look.
She ran away with another man. Him with no front teeth.
The doctor?
No, him we saw pissing on the McCulloch's dog. He's lemonade at it, my dad says.
The McCulloch's dog?
Oh, him with no front teeth.
Mrs. Hood, ran away with him?
Aye.
Some people have no taste.
Mr. Hood got taken away with the police this morning. He put his face through a plate glass window.
Was he trying to kill himself then?
Nah. He put him in the front teeth face through a plate glass window.
Oh, I see.
But she's back again.
Look, there's Morris.
He's away somewhere. Come on.
Something's not right here.
But the maps.
Space.
Here.
Ah!
How did you get in? The window? What do you want?
I won't hurt you. Harry Wilson. You are, aren't you? You like the charts? I've got some old ones. I'll throw them out anyway. Go on then. On you go. Lily, come and see me again. I'll show you the planets.
What happened? What did they do?
Nothing.
What do you mean? What did they say?
Nothing. I ran by them. They said nothing.
What can we do? Don't tell anyone.
Why?
They wouldn't believe us.
Did you see his eyes?
The glasses are a disguise.
Why has he got a disguise?
Because he's not from here. He's from somewhere else.
Where? Edinburgh?
No, stupid. He's a spaceman. He's got to be. I mean, Christ, pink eyes. We'll need proof. We'll write to Yuri Gagarin. Ask him. I'll do it. My dad's got envelopes. Best keep an eye on that, Morris. He might not be the only one. You should find out where he keeps his spaceship.
Keep watching the sky.
I've got as much right to do with my money as I want as anybody.
Your money? It's my money.
Our money.
Who's a bloody worker here?
If I want to go to night classes at the art school, I bloody well will, all right?
No, it's not all right. All right?
Dad.
What?
Did you know that Mr. Morris wasn't one of us?
Aye.
But, Dad, he's from another planet.
Oh, aye.
He's a spaceman.
That's right.
But, Dad, he's a thing from another world.
Related to your father, no doubt.
Are you sure?
Honest to God. God's honest. This car hasn't got an engine. He drives his car with no engine.
Everybody knows a car must have an engine.
It's a flying saucer. I'm telling you. Cross my heart and hope to die. No engine.
Thank you.
Are you all right, Grandad?
Just leave me. Away you go, son. Just leave me.
Now, America has a president. America is a republic. France has a president. France is a republic. Now, we are different. Why? Why? Why are we different? Does anyone know why we are different? No. Well, we are a monarchy. What do we have that America and France do not have? We have a queen. That's what we have. And what is a queen called? Anyone? Anyone? Ah, yes. Billy.
The queen is called a parasite, miss.
What did you say?
A parasite.
Go and stand in the corridor. And when the headmaster asks you what you are doing there, tell him what you told me.
What did you say?
I called the queen a parasite, sir.
My guess is, Chuck, it's a mineral resources reconnaissance trip. A preliminary survey followed by all-out interplanetary war.
Thank you, Laurel and Hardy. Well, ladles and jelly spoons, you all sitting comfortably. Because we'll have the next contestant in the Young Quarries Talent Competition. And it's going to be Mary Davison, and she's going to sing Nobody's Child. Big hand for Mary. Just be a minute. There's just going to be a wee break. Right, you'll just have to go on instead of her.
There's been a slight change to the agenda. It's now going to be the one and only Satchmo, Billy Wilson.
Get away. Shut up.
Rubbish. Get away.
Thank you, Billy Wilson. And now we'll have Mary Davidson doing nobody's child.
Out the way.
Oh, get out, children. Time was slowly passing. An orphanage one day. I stopped there for a moment just to watch the children play.
There's a photo of him too. Look.
When weightlessness set the major felt excellent, everything was easier to perform. Arms and legs weigh nothing, and objects float about in the room. I hung in mid-air. I felt fine, and my state of mind was excellent. I would like to go to Venus and see what is hidden beneath her clouds. I should like to visit Mars and see whether the planet has any canals.
Canals?
Aye, canals. The moon is not far. It says they'll be landing on it soon.
Preposterous.
Eh?
I wonder what planet Mr. Morris is from.
Venus or Mars?
Maybe he lives in a barge on one of the canals.
Could be.
People who live in barges are tinkers. Mars must be full of tinkers. Preposterous.
Shut, Billy. Shut up. You know nothing.
I wonder what his mission is then.
Aye.
Probably a mineral resources reconnaissance trip. A preliminary survey followed by all-out interplanetary war.
Burning bang.
No chance. I still need miners down there. And anyway, the shell's far too hot.
And in the United States, President Kennedy addressed the American people on the Berlin crisis. Has requested additional defense appropriations for the expansion of the armed forces. The president went on to say, "We have another sober responsibility to recognize the possibilities of nuclear war in the missile age. Without our citizens knowing what they should do and where they should go if bombs begin to fall, would be a failure of responsibility. This may herald a new start."
Come on!
You're not moving, they bloody brains. Just grow up.
His planet is overpopulated, like China, and he's down here looking for room for his mob.
Aye.
Billy, what are you doing?
I'm pretending the Furs are Catholics.
Your wee brother's soft.
Aye, again.
Don't move, Wilson. Not a muscle. See this? This is a real gun. How much money you got?
Nothing.
You're a liar.
Is it real?
It's only a slug gun.
Ah!
You what? You'll get a jail, so you will.
Oh, shut up.
I am bastard. Ugh.
What are you doing anyway?
Collecting for bonfire night.
Oh, I'll come with you, and I can shoot rats. But my dad says I shouldn't collect for bonfire night.
How?
Because Guy Fawkes was a Catholic and my dad hates orange men. It wasn't he that, Sayer?
Aye, it was.
What's he doing anyway?
He's pretending the Nettles are Catholic. German soldiers.
Oh, he's saft, Jimmy, bro.
It's too heavy. Here! Leave that! That's ours! We booked that!
That's
for our bonfire!
We saw it first.
It's ours! We were here first!
Leave him alone, you big bully!
My son!
Me. I haven't finished it. Don't slam the door on me. Open the door. Open the door. Open the bloody door. Nobody talks to me like that. Nobody. I'll cut your bloody teeth and open the bloody door. You missed, you stupid bitch. Pick them up. Pick them up.
Now get off.
I said pick them up. Pick. Christ, what do you think you're doing? Stop that. Stop it! You're off your head. You're no fit to be a mother.
Why do people marry people they don't like?
I'm not getting married. I'm not a girl anyway.
should be.
How are things, Harry? How are these young nurses treating you?
You all right? She'd never have gone that bloody march.
Oh, what's the point? He's away with the fairies.
Oh, hell.
He's the voice, Grandad.
Any fags?
You know you're not allowed any.
Look.
What is it, Harry?
It's a piece of paper, Dad.
Christ, so it is. I'm going off my head, won't you? I think I am, you know. Those bad as that old bastard over there. Last week, the fun having bathtub with all his clays on. He was reading the paper upside down. It's pathetic. Doesn't he know what bloody century it is? Aye, you. See who I'm talking about. He's got a Catholic face. They all look the same. Did you bring me any presents?
Yes, yeah, Grandad.
Walter hasn't been to see me. How's Walter?
Oh, he's fine.
Auntie.
They hate me. How's Walter? It's never on.
What is?
The telly. It's never on.
Shouldn't you say that?
Say what?
That. How's Walter? Fine. He's been dead 7 years.
What's the difference?
Did you see his hands?
Aye. His hands.
hands were all yellow. So was his face.
Don't change the subject. You know fine well it's the bloody Russians.
Och, rubbish, it's the bloody Yanks.
Away you go. Russia is a totalitarian state, that's what it is.
After the bomb, every country has an inner state. A state within a state.
Oh, come on, come on.
Oh, well, what about bloody America then, eh? Bloody Korea? Bloody McCarthy? What, some drunken gangster telling a whole country how they should think?
Well, away live in Russia then if it's such a nice place to be. Away live there then.
I never said that. I never said that. Don't put words in my mouth I never said. Look, if the Yanks keep building bombs, the Russians will keep building bombs.
And what would happen if they didn't? There'd be a red flag flying over Buckingham Palace.
Aye, well, that's no such a bad idea if you ask me. Hey, remember, it was the Yanks that dropped the bloody thing in the first place.
Quite right. They should have dropped one in Cuba as well.
Oh, listen to you. Listen to you.
Ach.
Dad!
What are you doing, boys?
We're guarding the bonfire.
Oh, come on, it's a bit late for that. Hey, you too, Sammy. Come on.
But, Dad! We've got to guard the bonfire for Spud McKenzie, or he'll set it up.
Why?
Because ours is bigger than his.
Oh, hell!
Hold yourself, Jim.
Oh, come on, boys, that's dangerous. You don't think it's big enough as it is?
Supposed to be bigger than theirs.
We'll stop when they stop.
But they won't.
So we won't.
Oh, but lads, if you keep building it up and up, it'll fall down.
5 minutes.
Think it looks like him then. I hear.
Should we put a space it on him, like Yuri Gagarin?
No. Whoever heard of a guy made up as a spaceman? Anyway, might get suspicious and zap us. We still don't know his mission yet. Look! Where did you get them?
The hangers!
I nicked them! Don't stop us!
Give us one then.
I dare you to hold it while I light it.
No.
Oh, go on, it's easy, I've done it.
All right.
Gets home, you're gone at a home. A home for boys that play with fireworks.
It's not fair. I don't want to go.
Well, it's too late for that now.
Oh. I got a phone call at work. Your dad's dead.
Can I go out and play with Alex?
Aye, go on, son. Would you look at this? He's got everything labelled so everybody knows who gets what.
There's a funny old bugger.
There's not much to show for a life down the pit.
No, not much.
Shut up.
Christ, I've forgotten about all this.
You can have these for your bonfire.
See if you can write your name. Shapes.
Get a boy some beer. Don't let anyone see you. You never got this off me, right?
Alex! Alex! creature.
You're a guy, am I?
No, you're a creature.
What are you talking about, son?
You're ugly. A creature from outer space. An alien being.
A spaceman?
Am I?
Stay where you are. Don't come any closer.
Well, well. An alien being.
Your disguise doesn't fool us.
My disguise?
Your dark glasses. You're not like us.
Your hair's white.
I'm not really a spaceman, lads. Come in. Come in if you want to. Take a seat.
Your mission?
I have no mission.
Polis will take you away. Being a spaceman's against the law.
I'm not a spaceman. I work in a bank.
Your car hasn't got an engine.
It has. It's a German car. It's back to front.
You've got maps of the stars and a big binocular.
Oh, that's a telescope, lads. I'm interested in astronomy. The study of the stars. Lots of people are.
Do you know Yuri Gagarin?
Yuri Gagarin? No.
Do you know God?
Shut up, Bully.
I never realised you hated me so much. I might have been a friendly alien for all you knew. I might have had great and wonderful stories to tell you about other worlds. I might have told you about planets where people could fly and the mountains were made of chocolate and small boys ran the government.
Don't be daft.
But you would never have heard about all these things because you would have burnt me to death. Even little children want to kill each other.
You're Catholic.
I'm Catholic in my interests. What a shadow we cast. It's dark in here because of my eyes. I suffer from refraction in the eyes and I don't like too much light. You see, I'm an albino.
An albino from outer space?
Liar. What's an albino then?
Someone who has homozygotes when they should have heterozygotes. 1 in 10,000 is like me. That's a lot.
That's shite.
I like watching the stars at night. They hold everything for me. Infinity.
What's infinity?
It never ends. That's what it is. The end that isn't there.
Ever and ever.
Don't think about infinity too much. You'll give yourself a sore head. Would you like to look into the telescope?
You can stick your telescope. Only watch.
The stars.
Took me 2 whole years to save up for this. 2 years. Hardly left the house economised. Never had lunch, but it was worth it. What about you two? Would you like to look into the telescope? It's a perfect night for it. You might see a shooting star.
Who cares about your stupid telescope? Billy, get away from him.
How many stars are there?
Who cares? Why do we have to count them? Maybe I'm a bit of an anarchist, even though I do work in a bank.
What's an anarchist?
Someone who doesn't like rules or being told what to do.
I'm an anarchist.
No, you're not.
Shut it.
Why weren't you at the bonfire then?
Fire hurts my eyes. Anyway, I'm not sure that death should be celebrated. Personally, I like the attitude of Fabius Maximus. He was a man who lived a long time ago. A great warrior called Hannibal came to conquer Fabius Maximus. And he couldn't understand his tactics. Hannibal had fought all over the globe, but Fabius baffled him. Why? Because he simply evaded battle. Hannibal, who was used to war, couldn't comprehend that. I like that story.
It's stupid, and I don't get it.
Maybe you will one day. Why don't you go home, boys? Go home. What? Stupid.
Come on, Billy! Did you see me smash it?
Aye.
We shot that day, we shot him. Oh, look! A shooting star.
Make a wish, make a wish.
I wish I had a spacesuit and a ranger strip.
I wish I had £1 million.
I wish I had a big car.
Quick, Billy, make a wish. I wish I had pink eyes.